Hello everyone. Today we will discuss about male reproductive system in plants. Actually, male reproductive system in plant consists of androecium and stamen. So we have to see the structure of this androecium, and mainly this androecium is consist of a long structure which is known as anther and a filamentous structure. Actually, in different types of angiospermic plant, we see that there are different types of anther, especially as far as lobes are concerned. These anthers, they are lobe-like structure, and in several flowers, we see that they have only single lobe structure. And these type of anther, which have only single lobe, they are known as monothesis anther. In this monothesis anther, what we see, they have two circular structure, which are actually the pollen sac. That's why they are also known as biosporogenate condition. And in maximum types of angiospermic flowers, especially 60% of them consist of two lobe structure. And in this two lobe, they are also known as diathesis anther, and they have tetrasporogenate condition. Means we see that they have four pollen sac-like structure, in which we will see that how the pollen grain used to form. Now we have to see the structure of these anther in detail, and there are different points of anther that we will see here. Now please pay attention here. See, this is the structure of male gamete, actually male reproductive part of flower, and it consists of a bilobe structure. This is known as anther, and a filament like structure, and this whole structure is situated over the swollen structure, which is known as thalamus. In sometimes we see that they are also attached over the petal in several condition. Now, the part of this anther or the filament which is attached to this thalamus is known as proximal end, and the part of this particular filament which is attached to the anther end is known as distal end. Now, anther is of two type, which I have already discussed, that is monothesis. They consist of only single lobe, and they are shown by the plants, especially of the Malvaceae family. And diathesis anther, and this diathesis anther is the most common variety of the anther which are shown by the different types of angiospermic flower. Now, as far as the attachment of anther to the filaments are concerned, we classify these diathesis anther into several types. See this. Actually, as far as these lobes are concerned, these lobes, there are two lobes, and in middle of these lobes, there is a structure, there is a cluster of esterized cell, which don't participate in the formation of pollen grain, and this is known as connective. Now, as far as attachment of these anther with filaments are concerned, we see that there are different types of anther. First one is known as basifix. What happen in the basifix condition, this anther is attached to the filament at the base point. Now, another type of anther is known as dorsifix. Here what we see, this filament, this used to attach at the dorsal end of the anther lobe. Now, the third type of anther, they are known as adenent. And in adenent, what we see that this filament is attached to the all along the length of the anther lobes. Now, this fourth one, this is a special type of adaptive feature which are shown by several anemomorphous flowers which show wind pollination. This type of anther are known as versatile anther. Here what we see, these anther, they are situated in a dangling condition. So whenever wind used to blow and the anther pollens are mature inside it, they used to come out very easily when they come in contact with the air. So these are the different types of anther, diathesis anther. Now we will see
how these anther, what are the internal changes which are happening inside these anther which lead to the formation of pollen grain. We will see the internal structure of these anther. This is also known as microsporogenesis. Microsporogenesis is actually the process in which microspore, that is the male gamete of the flower, pollen grain are formed. The cells of sporogenous tissues, they undergo several types of changes, especially the mitotic division to form a tetrad. These tetrad are the haploid cells which will further show different types of changes and will convert it into the pollen grain, which is actually the male gamete of the flower plant. See, actually what happened? There are a cluster of archaeospotal cells. These are the primitive cells, and these primitive cells, we will see that there are several types of differentiation which will be shown by them, and we get this tetrad structure, and this tetrad structure will develop into the mature male gametophyte structure which will lead to the development of pollen grain. Now this structure can be more easily understood by this diagram. This is the structure of a Biathesis anther, and what we see in a Biathesis anther, this is a TS actually. This is the anther portion, and we cut a section of this particular anther, then we will get in a structure, and in this structure what we are seeing, that is very important. See, we see two lobe, first lobe and second lobe, and there are four cluster of cells which we are seeing at the center. I will talk about this microsporangial cells later on. First of all the structure we will see one by one. This is the space between this particular epidermal wall and this internal microsporangial structure, and here we see this particular type of wall is made up of four different types of cells. And in this anther wall, which is made up of four different types of cell, the first wall is known as epidermis. See this, these are the epidermis cell. This is a single layer. In fourth layer, these are the first layer epidermis. These are single layer of flat cells. See, all the cells are flat in structure. Now then, there is a layer of a second layer which is known as endothecium. This is also endothecium layer. This is also a single layer cell. And these cells are radially arranged, and cellosa, thickening. These are the special type of cellular structure which are present between these endothecium cells, and these cellosa thickening, they play very important role in the digestion of the pollen. Now the third layer is known as middle layer, and these are loosely attached cells, and we see that they have two to three different types of layers which form the third layer. And the fourth one is the most important, which is known as septum. These septum, you can see in the diagram, blue color, these diagrams, they are actually conical cells you are seeing. These are pyramidal shape. They have very thick cytoplasm. They are multinucleated. And the main function of these layers, especially the septum layer, is they are the nutritive layer. They will provide nutrition to the microsporangial cells for the development. They secrete enzyme cellosa, which play very vital role in the process of digestion of the pollen. And they produces a UVS body, which are actually the coating, which will provide coating to the mature pollen. They are made up of a special substance which is known as sporopolline, and this sporopolline is the main constituent of the exine, which we will see in the next video when we will see the detailed structure of pollen grain. This is the strongest substance which are found in nature, and it can sustain very tough condition, high pH, high temperature, humidity. It can withstand each and every condition. So in next video, we will see how the male gametes are formed.